people go out and listen to music for very different reasons, but one of the main ones is escapism. Music is one of those art forms that really has the ability to completely take you to another emotional state, really, really quickly. DJing in front of a large group of people is more or less about ego. You are standing in front of hundreds, maybe thousands of people playing music to them. They're all having a good time, you're having a good time. No one should be getting paid to do this. It's a ridiculous job. Thirteen years ago, I had both arms amputated at the elbow, both legs about 6 inches below the knee. Kids will often ask me if I'm a robot or a pirate, and I tell them yes. The first time someone put these on me, I really didn't like them just because they were so foreign, it was such an alien object. But I started to get to like them a lot more just because, yeah, I don't know, they look cool, I guess. I just like them now. Having a visible disability is very different to having an internal or emotional disability. It's immediately identifiable and people will make assumptions about you. I once was waiting on the side of the road for my friend to bring the car around, and some guy threw change at my feet. I picked it up. I was recently in New York City with a friend, and we were having coffee at some place, and this middle-aged woman ended up buying my coffee, unbeknownst to me. And I knew it was because she thought that I had been in the war, I'd been in Iraq or something like that, and she was trying to do something good for a vet. And it was an internal conflict for me because I wondered whether I should go and sort of tell her that maybe the assumption she was making about me was wrong. But then I kind of realized that all she really wanted from this kind gesture was for me to say thanks very much and leave, which is what I ended up doing. But I mean, on some level, it does start to get to you a bit. Initially, you feel that it's your responsibility to manage people's misconceptions, and then you just get sick of it. You gotta go left on Little Regent Street there. I've probably had to answer like over 2,000 different taxi drivers as to what's happened to me, which is getting to be a bit tiresome for me telling the story, and therefore I usually swing them a bullshit story like a shark attack or was an acrobat for a while. I've had an illustrious career. I don't have a problem with people being curious or asking me what it is. It's a natural thing to do, but it's also natural for me to get extremely bored by it. Like, I'm sick of telling that story. I don't care anymore. If you care, you can Google it. Sup?
Hey.
Hiya. What's happening? When I first lost my limbs, I was unsure about what the future held. I didn't have an idea in my head of what people in that situation did.
Hear that clap, right?
Yeah. The more I got to do things for myself, the more I understood what was possible and what I was capable of. Then you start thinking to yourself, you know what? I could probably pretty much do anything if I just try doing it heaps. Notwithstanding, there are some things that I will never do, i.e. play a piano. But I mean, you gotta cut your losses. Not many people can play a piano anyway. I think that support groups are a fucking waste of time. From my perspective, I was asked to speak in front of a lot of amputees, and it was one of the worst things I've ever done in my life. It was like an endless procession of sad stories, and it was just, you know, dealing with the emotional pain of having lost a limb, and there's room for that, but there needs to be more room for moving on. It was a lot more healthy for me to be around able-bodied people who are just living normal lives, because if you're around people that are getting on with their lives, then you're going to get on with your life. Nothing that I've done has been made any more amazing by the fact that I have hooks for hands. But it becomes less about what you've achieved and more about the fact that you achieved it with a disability. The enjoyment that the crowd gets from what you do and making people have a good time is extremely rewarding. as soon as you stand up and DJ and you have the headphones on, it's just you and the music. And there's beauty in being alone in that situation. But being in the moment is very subjective, and a lot of people complain about fairly trivial things. There's the whole cliche, live every day as though it were your last, but no one does that. I don't even do that. That's ridiculous. People would be skydiving and f***ing in the streets. It would just be anarchy. Everybody is pretty much in whatever moment they're in. It's just making that moment something good. People will say, I could never have gone through what you have gone through, which is complete rubbish. Because people deal with adversity their whole lives. It's internal or it's emotional. It never gets commented on. And they just see someone in a physical position and say, I couldn't do that. Before this happened to me, I probably would have thought that I couldn't either. But I mean, you never know what you're capable of until you're truly tested.